Hi, to this Terdon, aircraft instrument. I received this one a few months ago and it appears I completely forgot to do a teardown of it. We have here a fuel used indicator in kilograms by the Eldec Corporation in Linwood, Washington. Yes. Manufactured in 79, part number, serial number 1062. And we have a Boeing part number, so it is obviously from a Boeing airliner. Apart from this, the model number of a light inside. And yes, Eldec Corp in Linwood, Washington. This is my inventory number, and on the screws here we have seals that are already broken from the airline or from the facility that did check this thing at some point in time. So what do we have in this? Four little screws. So at least this one is not welded together and can be opened. I hope so, at least. Yes. So usually when you open aircraft instruments, you will have a seal. So here, super big red rubber seal. And sometimes, actually, the back plate will have screws that will squish this seal to press it around the case, so sometimes you have to undo screws at the back to be able to open the aircraft instruments. It is good to know. So what do we have in here? First, the case is very regular, nothing special. They did not even bother painting the inside in black. So we have here some kind of glass fiber cover. I will undo for you, and apparently two little circuit boards. Obviously this one must be power supply with two power resistors here that did cook more or less the board under it quite badly actually. Sealed total end cap here, little transistors. Nothing special. Nice capacitors here with an NS1 logo. And here we have what must be some kind of servo control for this actuator. So it could be possible to test this. Because you can see on the front part we have just one motor apparently. With how many wires? Seems to be six wires. But it is what it is called, the trans. No, it is the brand, it is not the name of the device. We have the patent number, but it is not possible to read it. Except if I unscrew, but we have a annoying little nut here, so I will not undo it. So just one actuator of some kind, gears going to this counter. And of course some wires going to the front for your bulbs. Backlight bulbs. They are going probably here. Yes. Okay, so not much in this thing. Oh, the back piece did just fall. As you can see, it is done like such. big nut here securing the connector to the back piece. Okay. So quite a straightforward construction with just these big rods or standoffs. Another dead cord here, 78. And obviously you have two little screws here that will allow you to remove the part here and replace the little bulbs which are soldered to the board apparently. Okay, we have a micro switch here that might detect, yes, the end of travel. So somehow the thing must initialize at some point to reset the counting. And when it is done, yes, the all zero condition will press here onto a little metal tab and it will press this micro switch. Okay. So must be possible to power it on, but I have no time to do proper investigation on this thing. And the best that will happen is that having it moving, I am not sure about these resistors here. It seems it is quite well cooked, so maybe they are not good anymore. I can see the solder here did melt almost. Okay, it was probably removed because of a failure anyways. Nice Imperial hardware, of course, and super nice metal construction, you can see. So not a very complicated device, but very, very well constructed. So it will be all for this one, I guess. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.